In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Very good afternoon to all of you, my brothers and sisters. In a special way to two couples, coincidentally, that celebrate today their wedding anniversary. Marta and Javier, that are here, together with the distancing. And then also Sandra and Oliver, that together with the distancing, the different roles, have brought them to be so separated. One on top, the other one serving here. But we pray especially for them. We also pray in this Mass for the Thanksgiving intentions of Alexia Brink, Alma Olivar, Aline Olivar Princesa, Audrey Liao, Bas Brink, Bernadette On, Brenda Liu, Emmanuel Mack, again for Javier and Marta García Ramos, Lucas Gabriel On, Michael C., Oliver and Sandra Heden, Stephen and Conrad, and for the graces attributed to Our Lady of Fatima. We also pray for the special intentions of Adrian Liao, Benet Alviento, Michael San Juan, Michael C., Miyuki and Elvi, Peggy Pan, Shen Xiao, for the recovery of Father Liu Fong and the restoration of St. Joseph Church. We also pray for the souls of the faithful departed, those in purgatory, and also we especially pray for the faithful departed, Aldrin Olivar, Alexander Olivar, Aramanis and Rosarin Varela, Bertie Henry Dunker, Bertrand and Gladys Sea, Brigitte Hando, Clyde and Muriel Jonathan, Corey Tan, Dan Olivar, Dan Alexander Bansley, Derek and Monscully, Evangeline Olivar Santos, Helen Kams, May Siu, John and Mary Jonathan, Ko Kim Chen Peter, Lillian Lim, Lily Lin Siu Kiam, Lin Chuan Geok, Linnea and Eric Lundegren, Mariano Martinez and Rafael Alonso, Paul Chua, Percy Varela, Samuel Olivar, Sea Chuapo Robert, Stephen and Alfreda To, and for all the souls in purgatory. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins, and so to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of good will.
We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, by whose gift your faithful offer you right and praiseworthy service, grant, we pray, that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the things you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "If you fear the Lord your God all the days of your life, and if you keep all his laws and commandments which I lay on you, you will have a long life, you and your son and your grandson. Listen then, Israel. Keep and observe what will make you prosper and give you great increase. As the Lord God of your fathers has promised you, giving you a land where milk and honey flow. Listen, Israel. The Lord our God is the one Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength. Let this words I urge on you today be written on your heart." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. I love you, Lord, my strength.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
I love you, Lord, my strength. My rock, my fortress, my savior. My God is the rock where I take refuge. My shield, my mighty help, my stronghold. The Lord is worthy of all praise. When I call, I am saved from my foes.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
Long life to the Lord, my rock. Praise be the God who saves me. He has given great victories to his king and shown his love for his anointed.
I love you, Lord, my strength.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. There used to be a great number of priests under the former covenant because death put an end to each one of them. But this one, Christ, because he remains forever, can never lose his priesthood. It follows then that his power to save is utterly certain, since he's living forever to intercede for all who come to God through him. To suit us, the ideal high priest would have to be holy, innocent, and uncontaminated, beyond the influence of sinners, and raised up above the heavens. One who would not need to offer sacrifices every day, as the other high priests do for their own sins and then for those of the people, because he has done it once and for all by offering himself. The law appoints high priests who are men subjected to weakness. But a promise on oath, which came after the law, appointed the Son, who is made perfect forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please rise for the gospel acclamation.
Alleluia, alleluia. Your words are spirit, Lord, and they are life. You have the message of eternal life. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
One of the scribes came up to Jesus and put a question to him. Which is the first of all the commandments? Jesus replied, "This is the first. Listen, Israel. The Lord our God is the one Lord. And you must love the Lord, your God, with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this. You must love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than this. The scribe said to him, "Well spoken, Master. What you have said is true, that he is one and there is no other. To love with all your heart, with all your understanding and strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself. This is far more important than any holocaust or sacrifice." Jesus, seeing how wisely he had spoken, said, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." And after that, no one dared to question him anymore. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The central theme of the readings we just heard today is the most fundamental principle of, you could say, any religion that can be considered religion, as religion is religare, is relationship with God, God and ourselves, and God and ourselves and God. That tie, that rope uniting us to Him, is what is considered religion. And that's why today we read about this, and Christianity. We know very well, if somebody were to ask you as a Christian, can you summarize in one sentence the most important thing? What is all about to be a Christian? I don't know what you will answer. Oh, to be a Christian is to go to church every Sunday. Or to be a Christian is to be honest. Or to be a Christian is to give money to charities. Or to be a Christian is... Our Lord actually already gets the answer. And it's this. And our Lord, that's why, when there were so many, not the Ten Commandments, but when they're expanding, all the 613 precepts of the Torah, if you put them in line, you read 613 laws. And now you have the Pharisees, the experts in the law, the scribes, the Sadducees, the elders and the high priest, all of them trying to impose laws and laws and laws. It's something interesting to see that the prophet Isaiah reduced all these laws to 6. King David to 11. We read in one of the Psalms. The prophet Habakkuk summarized the whole thing in 1. And Jesus Christ, in this gospel, was bringing the whole summary of all the Torah, of all the commandments from God and so on, in these 2 that in reality is 1. Our Lord actually was bringing, in this gospel we have read, everybody to consider the Jewish Shema prayer. "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is Lord alone." There is only one. "That you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength." And to this Shema prayer, our Lord added, "And you shall love your neighbor as yourself." Something that is not new, because appeared already in the book of Leviticus, chapter 19. Our Lord in the Cenacle repeated that idea again. "A new commandment I give to you, that you love one another." And after 21 centuries, we could consider that the new commandment continue being new. Why? Because not so many people are practicing it. So much hatred, so much gossip, detraction, so many conflicts. And at the end of the day, it's because we Christians, we have not taken seriously this revolution of love. Loving God and loving our neighbor. I don't know whether you have seen, but it became viral this week. Many people were sharing this little thing on Facebook. And somebody discovered this little stall in the north of Singapore, Compassvale Street. Apparently there is a hawker center there. And there is a stall that is offering daily a number of free meals. And written there is said also that no questions will be asked. It's not that you go there, you need to justify. I don't know who is running this business. But knowing that many people are suffering, really, and they don't have money, they are offering every day a number of free meals. And they take, and I think it's around 30 or 50 meals, free meals every day. That is generosity. I don't mean that we need to do exactly the same thing. But we should ask ourselves every day, how many details of charity, how many details of service with the people around me, starting at home? It's something so important and so practical that brought Pope Benedict to write a long letter during his short pontificate, especially dedicated to Deus Caritas Est, but actually was dedicated to this topic of love. When he started saying that the word love is used by everyone, yeah, but this word, love, is already tarnished, spoiled, destroyed. So many people use the word love, but how many people really practice it to the limit? Loving God and loving the neighbor. Let me share with you one thing that happened to me yesterday when I was walking. As I took the booster this week, I was advised not to do exercise, strong exercise. I just went for a walk, and later on in East Coast, I spent a few hours reading. When I was coming back, in front of me, there was this middle-aged man in sport attire, walking fast like me, but he was in front of me. And he was actually pushing a prong, and I thought it was a baby inside because he was talking to the baby. Talking all the time, looking at him, I was behind. 5 minutes later, when I saw that many people, when I was walking, many people were coming in the opposite direction, were looking at this fellow, and also the baby, and all of them, they were laughing, they were smiling. Oh, what a beautiful thing, no? That this guy is spending the whole afternoon on Saturday just going for a walk with his baby and talking to him. Beautiful. 5 minutes later, he stopped. He was answering the phone. And then I passed by. I look around. And immediately saw that inside the prong actually was not a baby. It was a little dog. He was just going with the dog for a walk. And the surprise for me was talking to him. Of course, I cannot be judgmental, I don't know why. I was trying to think out whether is he married, that he had a baby, or really, or that he had children, or maybe he cannot have children, we cannot, I don't know. But sometimes it brought to my mind, considering this commandment of love, that sometimes we can love things, or animals, or vegetables, or flowers, more than people. And this is of course a trap. So many things that can occupy our hearts, and maybe it's not God and it's not our neighbor. And that's so interesting actually to do examination of conscience. Yesterday the Catholic Church, as part of the celebration of the Catholic 200 SG, there was a beautiful conference with many different panelists, speakers. And there was one of them, actually, who was mentioning the importance for businessmen or businesswomen, the importance of doing kind of examination of conscience. And somebody also added, including a retreat. Yeah. It's so interesting to really, every night, to the examination of conscience, maybe about these two questions. My love for God, how? Today. Or my love for my neighbor, today. It gives us an input, reasons to give thanks to God because with His grace maybe you have done many things. Or reasons to apologize because, Lord, today I really neglected so many opportunities. Or because today I thought too much in myself. Or because today and we formulate a resolution for the following day. This examination of conscience is having a very beautiful Christian custom to know how to rectify. In my country, there is a famous saying, it's the sabios, it's all wise people to know how to rectify. The examination of conscience makes us not only wise, wiser, but even holier. Let me finish with another example of loving God and loving our neighbor, or something that at least for me was very touching for many reasons. It's the story of a 15-year-old boy who was beatified 2 weeks ago, declared blessed, very close to my hometown in Cordoba, Spain, Montoro. The story happened 1 century ago during the Civil War in Spain, where around 1 million people died. It was a keen conflict between brothers for ideological reasons. Everything started because the Red Army started a real persecution to the church, and they killed thousands of priests, many bishops, many nuns, and many lay people. The conflict started on the 18th of July, 1936. My province, Córdoba, was very communist-oriented, but there were also many Catholics. In this little town of Montoro, immediately, 4 days only after the conflict started, the Red Army went to the house of this family, and they brought to prison, without any interrogations, to the head of the family, the father of this boy. After some interrogation, the Red Army came back to the same house because they heard about the Catholic activities as a catechist or the uncle of this boy. And they went back to the house, and when they were bringing this person also into prison, they saw the little boy, 15-year-old boy, in the pocket, was carrying a scapular. Part of it was coming out from the pocket of the trousers. Immediately, one of the soldiers told him to put this down and step on it. The boy said, no. Renounce your faith. 15-year-old boy, he said, no. Apparently, the boy was coming from this family who was very pious. He was serving as an altar boy. That's the reason why he was going to Mass every day, even. Was very efficient. He was finishing his studies and ready to go later on to a university college in Granada. But everything stopped there. He did not want to renounce his faith, his love for God. They brought him to jail also. They gave them 4 days to change his mind. He didn't. They killed him. He was declared blessed on the 16th of October, 2 weeks ago. What a beautiful example. Let the early Christians who gave their lives for the Lord and the blood of martyrs became the seed of more Christians. This example that for us can be like when we are struggling to do or not to do charity or to be faithful to our prayer. When we had the example of this boy who was faithful to the point of giving his life. These examples are so encouraging for all of us to be faithful to this commandment of Jesus Christ, loving God and loving our neighbors. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please let us raise for the creed and the prayers of the faithful. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord has commanded that we love God with our whole heart, soul, mind, and strength. Let us with great love and trust bring our needs and the needs of the world before Him, who is our rock and our salvation.
Our response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Church, the people of God, that we may always revere Him as the center of our life and abandon everything that lures us away from His love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Pope Francis, our Archbishop William, and all bishops and priests, that they who share in the ministerial priesthood continue to lead us to a deeper union with God, especially through the celebration of the Eucharist. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the lay faithful in our Archdiocese, supporting the synodal proceedings, let their discussions and honest interventions will bear fruit and give the Church fresh vision and vitality. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are seeking God or questioning their faith, that they may find in us good role models who live with fidelity, the self-giving love, and guiding light of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For individuals, families, businesses, and frontline workers who continue to be impacted by COVID-19, that our Almighty God will bring relief where it is needed most and restore all things in His time. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here, that we may be thankful for every person who is a channel of God's love in our lives, and for every experience of growth and loving God sends our way. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the intentions mentioned earlier in the beginning of the Mass and your own personal intentions. Loving God, you have brought us near to you through our great High Priest, your Son, Jesus Christ. Hear our prayers and grant them according to your will, for you alone are Lord. You made this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. great brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May this sacrificial offering, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation, and for us a holy outpouring of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
We give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. From when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gather them again to yourself, that the people form as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the Church. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously may holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, one supper was ended into the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave it the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, As we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance of your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, William, the Bishop of this diocese, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, when you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Invite those following the Mass online to join me in the spiritual communion and receive the blessing from the Lord. I wish, Lord, to receive you with the purity, humility, and devotion with which your most holy mother received you, with the spirit and fervor of the saints. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. You will show me the path of life, the fullness of joy in your presence, O Lord.
We are one.
Let us pray. May the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that renewed by these heavenly sacraments, we may be prepared by your gift for receiving the promise. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated for the final announcements. It's a gentle reminder that tomorrow, 1st of November, All Saints' Day Mass, will be here again in the Cathedral of the Good Shepherd at 6 p.m. Similarly, this is for vaccinated people, or those unvaccinated, they have to take the ART test before. Tomorrow, the Mass is at 6, but there will be another one for the community of the Cathedral after that. That's the reason they have advised us to leave the premises of the Cathedral as soon as possible. 2nd of November, it will be the All Souls Day. We will have at 10 a.m. the blessing of the graves at Chochukang Cemetery. A few of us will be there to bless the graves and to pray especially for all the faithful departed, those there and our relatives departed. This little prayer will be broadcasted via Facebook page of St. Joseph. And similarly, there will be another Mass here in the Cathedral at 6 p.m. Likewise, you are requested to leave the church premises immediately after Mass for the cleaners to be able to have time to sanitize the church for the next Mass. Number 3, the Rosary devotion that we do normally on Mondays to Our Lady of Fatima will not be done together at 8 because there will be a Mass here. There will not be so much time. We encourage everybody to say tomorrow the Rosary on your own. But on the 3rd of November, Wednesday, at 4 p.m., we have the traditional Rosary with the Litanies to St. Joseph, for this year especially dedicated to St. Joseph. Before giving the final blessing, we'd like to invite the two couples that are celebrating today anniversary, Sandra Ross, Oliver, to come here in front of me, in front of the altar. This is a surprise. And also to Javier and Marta, please come forward to receive a special blessing for both of you, both couples. In Sanchez, please come. I will not ask the couples to be distanced because anyway they are living together. And what the Lord has put together, not even the virus can separate. So you can stay 2 days and 2 days. Many churches, from time to time, they organize couples that are celebrating their anniversaries to come to renew. We are not going to ask you any questions, don't worry. But the question has been answered already by your fidelity. Through these years, if I am not wrong, 23 and 29. So approaching 30 next year will be a big celebration. St. Joseph Church with some couples are celebrating, all of them, 30 years, Marianne and many others. And you, I think you will be in Mexico by that time when you celebrate the 25 years silver anniversary. But we pray not only for these couples, but those couples who are married, but these are representing all of you, receiving again the blessing of the Lord. O Lord, God Almighty, 23 years ago, today, in Spain, and 29 years ago, in Singapore, these two couples were expressing their desire of fidelity to one another, to honor you all the days of my life, in sickness and in health, and so on. After so many years of fidelity, these couples and those married here, they're asking for your blessing your graces to continue in that fidelity. With you, everything is possible. Without you, we are nothing. We ask you to bless them, to bless their children, their grandchildren, or the grandchildren to come. Bless everything that is in these families, and in all the families of the world. Lord, protect us, because it's your will, and you can yourself through Jesus Christ, who were born in a family, the family of Mary and Joseph. May the great patriarchs and Joseph and Mary be the model of all fathers and mothers for those families in the world. Bless them and bless all their intentions in a special way today. The Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Our family was celebrating 30 years. And let us finish here because otherwise we become emotional, we start crying, and it's not the time. Let them congratulate themselves. We pray for them, and we pray for all the families, all the couples here. Please let us pray for the final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Let us say together, Hail, Holy Queen. Mother of mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. Today we cry, poor banished children of Eve. Today we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Then the most gracious advocate, the eyes of mercy towards us. And after this, our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of the womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, in the prayer to St. Michael the Archangel, St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the other evil spirits, prowl through the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.